So welcome back to the next Lightning Talk at ThayaCon. Please introduce Mark Suyev. He's a developer tools engineer at Typeflux. He's especially interested in designing solutions for other software engineers. At Typeflux, he is mostly involved in their open source activities, building the new language engineering framework, Langium, as well as being a regular core contributor to Thea. Aside from his engagement in the maintenance of Thea as a contributor and reviewer, he built the internationalization framework during the last few months. That's what he's going to talk about now. So take it away, Mark.
Thanks, Brian. So yeah, hello and welcome. I'll be talking about the internationalization feature. For those who haven't actually seen it yet, Thea is now available in different languages. For example, Chinese or French or different other languages as well. And while the base framework of Thea is quite well localized by now, utilizing the internalization feature of Thea in your own extension requires some work, which is why I'll now explain how it works and how you would use it. So basically, everything described and how it works is done in this diagram. So let's start at the bottom of it. Once the backend starts, any deployed plugins will be read by the plugin scanner, and that includes VS Code language packs, which were installed by the user or packaged with the Thea application. And these are transformed into key value pairs of the respective local, and afterwards pumped into the localization service, which is quite key here. The same actually happens with localization contributions, which are the default way to provide localizations for your extensions in the backend. And once the user actually loads the application and has switched their local to a different than English, the localization loader will request every translation available for that local. This is done during import time. And afterwards, it will create a statically available localization object, which can be accessed during using the NLS namespace, which is imported in the Thea core package. And since any localizations are imported before actual import time of your extension code, you can actually use it to localize things like commands, which is quite crucial as they're usually defined during import time. And so after having loaded everything, also dialog, widgets, menus, and so on can use the NLS namespace to perform localization on the front end. And of course, one has to mention that the mechanism works for both browser as well as the electron environment. And so after having explained how to use it, how does one use it? So let's say you have an extension that greets and says goodbye to a user. We create a widget, for example, that simply displays a by message, which you can see here in the first code snippet. And it renders it using the NLS localized function. And the first argument here is the translation key, which is a unique identifier for the translated message. And the second argument is the English default value that will be used in case no local has been selected by the user. Also, as template expressions and string interpolations don't really play well with the localizations. The localize function also provides formatting capabilities, as you can see here in the second snippet. And also to improve developer experience, there's a utility function to easily localize commands, for example. The first argument here is, of course, the command to be localized. The second argument is the localization key for the label. And the third is the key for the category. And now that you've successfully localized the front end, you of course need to translate everything that you've just localized. So you can run the Thea NLS extract CLI command to create a simple JSON key value file that contains every key and value that you just created, you are using for the NLS localized function as well as the command translation utility. And now you can use any manual or machine translating approach and so on, also a translation or localization service to generate different JSON files for different languages. And these just have to be registered inside of the localization contribution, which I've also mentioned earlier in the diagram. So you can see localization registered for German, Italian, Chinese, and so on. And this localization contribution just has to be bound using the usual inversify mechanism. And afterwards, you're actually done. Your extension is now available for different locals. And yeah, that's it, actually. The code snippets are lifted straight from the FIA docs on internationalization. So in case you didn't catch something, you can read it up there as well. So yeah, that's it. Thank you for listening.